Ozymandias by P.B. Shelley. Ozymandias is a sonnet composed by P.B. Shelley. Well, we have already discussed the meaning of sonnet in Not Marble, Not the Gilded Monuments. Now, let's discuss it once more. A sonnet commonly has 14 lines. The term sonnet is derived from Octavian word sonnet and the Italian word sonetto. Both means a little song. Ozymandias is another name for one of the Egypt's famous ruler, Ramses II or Ramses the Great. He was born in 1314 BC and died in 1234 BC. He ruled Egypt for 66 years. He was a warrior king and built several temples, statues and monuments. Now, let's start the poem. The poet says that he met a traveler from an antique land who told him that the two big and trunkless, well, the meaning of trunkless is without the upper body. Now, let's get back to the poem. Legs of stone were standing in the desert, and near them on the sand, half sunk, lay a shattered face whose facial expression was something like this: frowning, lips are wrinkled, and facial expression is also of scorn and hostility, in which the upper lip is raised. It was the sculptor who converted these facial expressions into the writing, which was still there on the lifeless thing. Can you tell me what does the poet want to convey through these lines?
No, ma'am.
Okay. The poet want to say that the so-called powerful king Ozymandias had died several years ago, but the sculptor's sculpture is still in existence. The bottom line is that the sculptor was more powerful than the king. Reason being, as mentioned earlier, the king died many years ago, but the sculpture and the writing on it still exist. On the pedestal of the statue, the king's words are written: my name is Ozymandias, king of kings. Look upon my works, ye mighty, and disappear. It is an ironic statement of his pride. In the last paragraph, the poet says, nothing remains. Decay is the ultimate destination. Even the authoritarian rule finishes. The poet wants Britain. The same could happen to it if it doesn't change its ways. Read the following abstract and answer the questions by choosing the most appropriate options. I met a traveler from an antique land who said two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert. Near them on the sand, half sunk, a shattered visage lies whose frown and wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command. What do you mean by antique land? A land with lot of population, a land where families live, a very distant land with a very few people, none of the above. The answer is none of the above. Who belonged to antique land? P.B. Shelley, the traveler, Ozymandias, or the sculptor? The answer is the second one, the traveler. It was the statue of Ozymandias' wife, the traveler, Ozymandias' son, or the Ozymandias. The answer is the fourth option, Ozymandias. Answer the following questions in 30 to 40 words. According to you, who was more powerful, Ozymandias or the sculptor? Answer: according to me, sculptor was more powerful, as Ozymandias died several years ago and there was nothing of his remaining, but the statue was built by the sculptor when Ozymandias was alive. Although the king died, but the sculpture still existed after so many years. Therefore, in my view, the sculptor is much more powerful than the king. Second question: on the pedestal it was written, my name is Ozymandias, king of kings. Look upon my works, ye mighty, and despair. From these lines, what can you tell about the nature of Ozymandias? The answer is, from the above lines, one can say Ozymandias was an arrogant king who was extremely proud of his achievements. one can also say that he thought he was the best and beyond comparison with other people. Now, there is a long question. Imagine you are Ozymandias, you have come back to life and see your statue still exist. Write a diary entry in not more than 50 words. Read the following abstract carefully and answer briefly the questions that follow. I met a traveler from an antique land who said, two vast and trunkless legs of stone stand in the desert. Near them on the sand, half sunk, a shattered visage lies whose frown and wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command. The first question goes something like this. Where was the statue situated? The answer?
The statue was situated in the desert.
Right. Second question. What was the facial expression, wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command symbolize? The facial expression, wrinkled lip and sneer of cold command symbolize the pride and haughtiness of the king. Where was the face of the statue? The face of the statue was lying on the sand near the two big and trunkless legs of stone.